I'll just write down the question. It's 1.1.4. It's given as x squared minus 2x minus 8 less than 0. So these are inequalities, guys. This question is allocated 3 marks. Let me just note it down there so that I don't forget to show you where you score your marks. So guys, with regards to inequalities, I think I must do a special video where I take you through these inequalities, because you might not fully understand how we arrive at the final answer. But guys, because all of this is equated to zero and you cannot further simplify this, and for the fact that it's given 3 marks, it means it's not that much complicated. We won't have to go through a lot of steps, so you can just straight away factorize. You get the factors. Obviously, this is also not complicated to get the factors. You know, you've got 4 and 2. When you multiply this by that, it gives you 8. Okay, so again, you obviously know this is a negative sign, this is a positive sign, so that when you say negative 4, a positive 2, it gives you negative 2. Okay, so there's something called critical values, guys. Critical values comes from your factors. You know, that's where your x is equals to 4, or your x is equals to negative 2. Okay, so you can just draw that and indicate that you've got negative 2, you've got 4. So obviously these are your critical values. So now, because of that sign which is less than, that's where you have those circles there, and then after having those circles, this is where you then now to you then need to indicate by means of arrows if you'll be having an arrow in that direction, an arrow in that direction, or you'll be just joining those two circles. Guys, this is where you need to use your calculator. So the question is, for which values of x will all of this be less than zero? We know a number which is less than zero is a negative number. So guys, let's pull out our calculator and do this exercise. So we're going to check for values, from negative 2 going in that direction. We'll check with the values in between. We'll check with the values in greater than 4. So now let's first start with maybe negative 5. So what you do, you pull out your calculator. In place of x, we substitute negative 5. So it will be open negative 5 close squared minus 2 into negative 5 close minus 8. Let's punch it's equals to I'm not really sure of where I made a mistake, but I'll just redo it. So it's negative 5, you close bracket, you square, minus 2 into negative 5, you close, and then you minus 8. It's equals to, can you see, you get a positive number. We are not really interested about that number, because we could have used any other number, as long as it's a number which is less than negative 2, or a number on this side of negative 2. So we just want to see a sign if it's positive or negative. So we've just noticed that it's a positive number, which means a positive number is greater than zero. So it's not what we are looking for. So let's try with a number between these two critical values. Then you substitute, you can maybe substitute negative 1, you can substitute 0, 1, 2, 3. Those are the numbers which are between these two critical values. So I'll substitute 3. The other one, please substitute a different number. You can substitute negative 1 or 0 or 1 or 2. I'm going to substitute 3. So when I substitute 3, can you see I'm getting a negative number? I'm not interested in the actual number that I get. I just want to know the sign. Okay? So when I punch when I punch a number which is between negative 2 and 4, I get a negative answer. So now let's try another number which is on this side of positive 4. I'm going to just maybe use 95. The other one, use a different number as long as it's greater than 4. Okay, it's equals to, can you see I'm getting a positive number? So I'm only interested in the sign of that answer. So can you see, guys, this equation, when we interpret it in words, we are saying for which values of x, when you substitute on this equation, will be less than 0. So guys, this is where you just join these lines. So what you're basically saying is that between negative 2 and 4, that's where the values of x, when you substitute there, are less than 0. How do we know they are less than 0? It's because all of them, when you substitute there, you get a negative number. And we know a negative number is less than 0. But when you substitute values from negative 2 going that side, they give you a positive sign or a positive number, which is obviously greater than 0. So it's not part of the answer. So you can either answer, give this as your answer, or you can say that's where x is between negative 2 and 4. So always when you see this, guys, when you want to interpret this in words, it simply means a between negative 2 and 4. So it means x is between negative 2 and 4. If you see something like 7, let's say less than maybe y less than 4. In words, this thing, it means y is between negative 7 and 4. That's what it means, guys. So otherwise, you can also give this answer differently by saying that's where x is less than 4, or where x it's less than negative 2. Okay, so this is how you can give answers to this question, guys. So before I forget, I have to show exactly where you score your marks. So you will get your first mark there, where you were able to give us the factors. The other mark comes from critical values, and then the other mark comes from the final answer. Okay, so that's how you solve this question, guys. I hope you are now ready for the next question. In case if you didn't understand, you can just post a comment in the comment section, then I'll attend to that question. But one thing for sure, I have to do a special video where I just do inequalities. The other one, remember guys, you can even show by means of a graph where you do something like that, where your graph touches those two critical points. So there are a lot of ways in which you can give the final answer, guys. So a good question might be asked. One would say, what if it was less and equal to? So that's where in those circles you make a solid circle. It's not an empty circle. So that's the difference. So guys, let's have a glass of water and get ready for the next question. So I assume you're now fully ready for the next question.